Sharing a segment from the book Nigel and the Little Ones, sharing chapter 9. The story is about an indoor, fluffy cat named Nigel, who becomes friends with a squirrel named Bounce and a chipmunk named Ben, and in this chapter, he becomes friends with the great wise owl. Read by the author. I woke to see the sunset. When the days are warm, I sleep, and I tend to allow my afternoon nap become many hours. I walked to the patio door window to see in the shadows of the branches a large bird I had never seen before. I yawned and adjusted my position to get a better look at what was gazing back at me. With the window still being open, I could speak through the screen, but I didn't want to speak, for I didn't know who this was. Where did this large bird come from, and where is Bounce and Ben? I studied this large silhouette, and as I was gazing, I could see very large eyes looking at me. I found my courage and I whispered softly, "Hello?" The large face looked upon me and I could feel my heart race, and at the same time, I wasn't scared at all. In fact, this bird had such a presence. He looked noble and grand. I wasn't scared. "Hello," a deep voice whispered back. "I have never seen you here before. I have never seen a bird like you before. I have never seen a cat with such a furry face." I smiled, knowing my face was fluffy. "Where are you heading? Do you live here? Do you come here often and I just haven't noticed?" He looked down upon the house and focused his large eyes to mine. "I live yonder. I noticed this beautiful backyard and I just stopped to appreciate the beauty. My human feeds many here. Would you like something out of the feeder?" "You are kind to offer, but what I eat isn't found in a feeder." I took his word that what he ate, I didn't want to know about. "Do you have a name?" I asked. "Yes, I have a name. My name is Arthur, but most call me Rudd." "Rudd, that is unusual." "Yes, yes it is. I like it that way. Rudd, or shall I call you Mr. Rudd?" "Please call me Rudd. It is short for Ruddsdale." His name was as noble as he was. He stood tall and regal. He stood strong and could look around at many things, across many miles, I am sure. His eyes were as large as saucers. "Rudd, what kind of bird are you?" Rudd smiled softly and replied, "I am an owl." "What is your name?" "My name is Nigel. I am a very fluffy cat." "I can see you are fluffy, and I have heard about the cat that lives inside this home." "You have heard about me?" I asked, wondering who would talk about me. "I have a good friend, Bounce, and he shares many things with me. We talk about the things we like, and you, Nigel the cat, he likes very much." I blushed. I didn't know what to say, so I simply returned the words, "Thank you for sharing. I think the world of Bounce. There is a chipmunk. His name is Ben. He is the one that has a shorter tail." "I know Ben, and since he is also a good friend of Bounce, I allow Ben to just live life." "Live life? I don't understand." "Owls eat smaller animals." "What?" I knew I didn't want to hear. "I see," I said as I nodded my head. "I know I could have been for lunch, but now since we are all friends and it is frowned upon by my human, Ben does get to live life." "Cats tend to eat mice," he said, looking around from his perch. "Yes, sir, we do enjoy mice, but I'm not allowed to eat those either." He looked about, his eyes becoming larger. He made this echo sound, and it was felt in my heart. It must echo through the lands. Sir, I mean Rudd, you won't have been for lunch, right?
Nigel, I am true to my word and true to my friends. I will not have been for lunch.
I nodded, feeling still comfortable in his presence, but he sure had a grand presence. I almost wanted to kneel.
Nigel, I hear from Bounce that you are pondering your creation by creation.
Yes, sir, I mean, Rudd, I am. I never thought about it until I met Bounce and Ben. They tell me all about this Creator, and so much I do understand, and so much I do not understand.
Tell me, Nigel, tell me what you don't understand.
The owl looked wise. He was so strong in his presence, his balance, his everything.
Well, as I spoke, the sun continued to set.
I don't understand where I was before here, and I don't understand why there is cruelty and unkindness. I don't understand why we would even eat a mouse or a chipmunk. I don't understand about the cycle of life. I don't understand life and death.
The wise owl gazed about. He sat in stillness for a long while, and I knew I was to remain in my own silence to hear the whisper that I could feel, the whisper from Mother Earth, the whisper from my heart.
Nigel, you have asked many questions. Let us first start with the creation of you. Nigel, there are no mistakes in the universe. There are no mistakes to your creation of you. You are divine perfection of you. I looked down at my fluffiness. I, for the first time, I could see the perfection of me. I could see that I am the only me there is. I could see that with the chipmunks all looking the same, they still had their uniqueness and qualities that were different from the others that they looked similar to. I nodded as the owl continued.
The Creator is all. The Creator is me, is you, is this tree. The Creator is Mother Earth and all upon Mother Earth.
I nodded. I understand that. I understand the Creator is something that is in all because it created all. But what does the Creator look like?
Nigel, look at yourself.
I looked down once again at me.
I am the Creator? The Creator looks like me?
You are part and piece of creation. Therefore, you are the Creator as you.
I am the Creator as me. Bounce is the Creator as Bounce, and Ben is the same.
Do you think this Creator would sing songs that rhymed? I asked with a smile.
The Creator is the song. The Creator is the tune, is the words.
Nigel, the Creator is your human and the wood in your home.
I nodded.
But why did the Creator not just create nice things? If the Creator is all, why isn't it only nice things?
When all was created, it was understood that all would be able to make a choice.
That is what Ben and Bounce have been saying.
Ben and Bounce are clever ones.
I nodded, knowing my new friends were clever and kind, knowing my new friends treated me as though we knew each other for years.
Nigel, think of your choices as what is called free will. The Creator chose to create each with free will.
Nigel, free will is just that, free will, the will to choose. I understand, but I don't understand. Why would anyone choose to be cruel? We eat mice and others, but we aren't cruel about it.
Nigel, this is true. We are not cruel about it, and we understand the blessing of life itself. Nigel, we understand that nature is nature, and that each comes to walk upon Mother Earth for grand reason. Are you saying that mice are here so we can live and they can die? That doesn't make sense to me. Nigel, we all leave the world we know. We change locations. We all at one time leave. I nodded, feeling rather sad that one day I will be leaving, that my human will be leaving, Ben and Bounce and Rudd and the mice will all be leaving. Think of the departure from Mother Earth to the great heavens, a change of eternal location. A change of location? Well, that sounds good, but we wouldn't be here. Nigel, you are peace and part of divine. Where is divine? I shrugged my shoulders. Is that the same as the creator? Nigel, there are many words to call the creator. I like the word divine. It does sound very nice. So, Nigel, my newfound friend, if you are part and piece of divine, and divine, the creator is all, in all places, in all things, would it make sense to you that you, once traveling to the heavens, becomes only part of all? Think of departing Mother Earth as becoming eternal light. Eternal light, I sighed, wanting to understand. The owl was wise, and I wanted to be as wise, so I continued to listen. Nigel, you asked the question, where was I before here? And the answer, Nigel, is truly rested in your heart that whispers so gently to you. I can feel my heart. I can hear my heart, not with words, with, I don't know, with a presence. I can hear my heart without words being spoken. Who do you think hears the unspoken words? I looked at the grand owl, who continued to gaze about his surroundings, always moving his head back and forth, looking. The creator? Ah, my dear friend, you are wise. And not only the creator, for many that live in the heavens communicate with you through your heart. I liked what I heard. I could feel my heart at ease. I could understand a little better, but still, I didn't know where I was before here, and do I truly go to the heavens? Nigel, what are you looking at? My human asked as she walked into the room. She came in to see, and she could see the wise owl in the tree. Nigel, look at that! Look at that! Nigel, what a grand owl! Did you know, Nigel, that owls are wise beyond measure? I rubbed my head against her leg. She knelt down to rub the top of my head as the owl gazed into the window. Look, Nigel, he sees you. I purred, knowing that I could speak to the wise one. Nigel, please come upstairs as it is getting dark. She gazed once again at the beauty and magnificence that was presented before her. I wanted to stay to hear more, and then Rudd spoke to me. Nigel, come to this window tomorrow evening at sunset, and I will be here, and we will find your answers that you are seeking. I looked up at my human, who was in awe of Mother Earth, and I too was in awe of the beauty that surrounded us. Say goodnight to your friends, Nigel. Goodnight, Rudd. Goodnight, Ben. And Bounce, wherever you are. My human closed the window, and I knew that I was blessed beyond what I once knew to be. For only days before, I didn't know the Creator, and now I feel that I am part and piece of the Creator. I am loved. I love. It is about love. Just then, I realized the Creator created love. For that is who I am. This concludes chapter 9. Thank you so much for listening.